Hi students, today we are discussing about the anomalous expansion of water. Okay, in general, all liquids, okay, if you take any liquid except the water, in case of general liquids, when temperature rises, expansion of liquid takes place. Okay, when temperature decreases, contraction of liquid takes place. Okay, but in water this is not possible. Okay, in water, for suppose, let us take certain amount of water. Water contains water molecules, na? Okay. For suppose it is at a room temperature, 25 degrees Celsius. Okay. Now, the temperature of water is reduced. When temperature is reduced, then all the molecules are come closer together. That's why all the molecules now come very close together. So their volume is decreases. Okay. And the temperature now you reduce at 4 degrees Celsius. Water has maximum density or minimum volume. Water has maximum density or minimum value at 4 degrees Celsius. Is it clear? So this is the usual thing. But whenever the temperature reduced further, means lesser than 4 degrees Celsius, the water molecules are is not possible to come closer because it has the minimum volume now. Now here the water molecules are spread apart. That means the gap between the water molecules is increases. Okay, so whenever the temperature is reaches to the 4 degrees Celsius to the 0 degrees Celsius, the gap between molecules increases, means water expands. Water expands. This is an unusual thing. Okay, it is the usual thing, but it is the unusual thing. This unusual thing is named as anomalous expansion. So what is the meaning of anomalous? Anomalous is nothing but unusual expansion of water. It is takes place exactly at 4 degrees Celsius. Why? At 4 degrees Celsius, water has maximum density or minimum volume. Understand now. If the temperature is reduces further, so here again expansion takes place, we said, na? So water molecules now like this. If the temperature is reduces further at 0 degrees Celsius, now water is changes states into the ice. Okay, understand? So at 4 degrees Celsius, what happens? If the temperature is reduces, then expansion of water takes place. But in generally, and temperature reduces, contraction of all other liquids, but water expands at 4 degrees Celsius. This unusual behavior is known as anomalous expansion of water. Is it clear? So, for water, on cooling, it contracts up to 4 degrees Celsius. See, from 25 degrees to 4 degrees Celsius, it contracts. Okay, this is a usual thing, like all other liquids. But exactly at 4 degrees Celsius, water has maximum density or minimum volume now. That's why from 4 degree Celsius to 0 degree Celsius, it expands. It is unusual behavior. Similarly, I'm heating from 0 degree Celsius to 4 degree Celsius, it contracts. And more than 4 degree Celsius, like other liquids, it expands. Okay, so these two are unusual behavior. This is called anomalous expansion of water. Is it clear? So, if you take water in a vessel exactly at 4 degrees Celsius, I take some water in a glass at 4 degrees Celsius. If you heat it more than 4 degrees Celsius, expands. That's why water expanded out. Understand? If you cool from 4 degree to 0 degree Celsius, again expands now. So water again expelled out. Or understand? Exactly at 4 degree Celsius, if you cool the water or heat the water, water will be expands. That is the most important thing. Clear? Now, what are the consequences of anomalous expansion of water? The first one is, at 4 degrees Celsius, water has maximum density or minimum volume. And the second one is, the density of ice is lesser than that density of water. Okay, this is also an unusual thing. Why? Because maximum solids, all the molecules are very tightly bounded with each other. That's why their density is always more than the liquids. But for ice only, the density of ice is lesser than the density of water. That's why if you take some amount of ice on water, then it always floats. Okay, we are experienced that one. Within the cup of water, if you place an ice cube, then it always floats. Understand? This is about anomalous expansion of water. Okay? And some aquatic animals survive in very cold conditions. So fishes or sea bears, polar bears, seals, like that. Even at very cold conditions, they survive. How it is possible? Okay, let us discuss that one. So, I am considering one lake or pond or a river in cold countries. Okay, we know in cold countries, the atmospheric temperature is very less. Okay, if the temperature reaches lesser than zero, for example, if the atmospheric temperature reaches to minus 20 degrees Celsius, then what happens? Let us see. In this water, we have huge number of water molecules on the surface. Now, when the atmospheric temperature reaches less than 0 degrees Celsius, these water molecules loses their temperature and they become denser. So, these water molecules moves down to the bottom of the lake. Due to convection, some water molecules reaches the surface of the water. Again, they cools down, they come down. So that's why all the water molecules due to convection, they are continuously transfers their energy from one molecule to the another molecule until the entire water is at 4 degrees Celsius. Okay, temperature reduces. Here the temperature of water reduces continuously until 4 degrees Celsius. We know at 4 degrees Celsius, water has a special behavior called anomalous expansion of water now. Because at 4 degrees Celsius, density is maximum and volume of the water is minimum now. So what happens at 4 degrees Celsius? At 4 degrees Celsius, this further convection is stopped. So no transfer of heat from the one molecule to the another molecule. The entire convection is stopped now. So there is no this type of convection. Understand? So at this position, what happens? The water molecules which are on the surface of the lake are cools to 0 degrees Celsius. Whenever they cools to 0 degrees Celsius, they freezes into the ice. So this is ice. So in region 1 means on the surface it is ice, and in region 2 we have the water. Understand now? We know ice is at temperature of 0 degree Celsius. So at bottom we have 1 degree Celsius. Immediately some layers are at 2 degree Celsius. Some layers are at 3 degree Celsius. But the remaining entire water is only at 4 degree Celsius. So the bottom of the lake, the temperature is generally 4 degree Celsius. Understand now? And it forms an ice on the surface. And we know ice is a bad conductor of heat. That's why it does not conduct the heat from the region 1 to the region 2. So that the temperatures in the inner side is always maintained at the same. Means just below the ice, temperature is 1 degree Celsius. After that 2 degree, after the 3 degree, after that the entire water is at 4 degree Celsius. Understand? If the atmosphere temperature is reduces further, then the thickness of ice layer is increases. Understand? If the temperature is reduces, then the thickness of ice layer will be increases on the outer side. Is it clear? So, if the atmosphere temperature is lesser than 0 degree Celsius, in water, in river, on the surface of water only, there is some growth of ice is there. Below that pot, water is remains at 4 degree Celsius. So heat is in liquid state now. So fishes or seals or polar bears are survive within this water even the temperature is very less. Understand? So this is another consequence of the anomalous behavior of water. So what are the consequences? So the first one is water has maximum density as 4 degree Celsius. The second one is density of ice is lesser than density of water. And third one, aquatic animals survive in very cold conditions. Okay, this is about anomalous expansion of water. Okay, let us see applications of expansion of liquid. One of the application is condition for unoccupied volume present in a container containing liquid to remain constant. Okay, they want some condition for unoccupied volume present in a container remains constant. For that, let us see, this is one container now. So volume of the container is taken as Vc, and coefficient of volume expansion of container is taken as gamma c. Within that, we have taken some liquid whose volume is Vn, and gamma L is the coefficient of the cubical expansion of liquid. Okay, so here this portion is called unoccupied volume. Right now, because within the Vc up to this level, I fill it with liquid now. So what is unoccupied region? This is only about the unoccupied region. Okay. Now, temperature of this vessel is increases. Whenever you increase the temperature, we know vessel is expands and also liquid is expands. Okay. So vessel expands, liquid expands, and we know that expansion of liquid is more, but he says unoccupied volume of the container remains constant, means this portion is not possible to change. Is it right? Whenever you raise the temperature, even though he said unoccupied volume is always remains constant, this is only possible when expansion of container is equal to expansion of liquid. Okay. If expansion of container is equal to expansion of liquid, then only unoccupied volume is always remains constant. Otherwise, it is not possible. So, what is the formula for expansion of container? This is denoted by delta Vc, na? So, delta Vc is equal to delta Vn. Delta Vc formula, Vc gamma C delta T. And delta Vl formula, Vl gamma L delta T. We are discussing this in the previous section. If you have any doubt, please verify the previous video. Okay, so here delta T cancel. Then we have one formula, Vc gamma C is equal to Vl gamma L. So, condition for unoccupied volume remains constant has Vc gamma C is equal to Vl gamma L. Understand? So, this is the first application. So, the second application is the condition for amount of liquid expelled out. Okay, for that I am considering a vessel and within that I fill it with some liquid except water. Okay, so are you observe this one now? The entire vessel is filled with liquid means the volume of container is equal to the volume of liquid. Let it will be V. Okay, and the temperature initially at T1 degree Celsius. Just I assumed this one. Understand? Now, if you heated this one, then what happens? If you heated, we know vessel is expands. Liquid also expands. So, what is the expansion of vessel? Expansion of vessel is delta Vc is equal to Vc gamma C delta T, and expansion of liquid is delta Vl is equal to Vl gamma L delta T. We know these two. Now, what he was asking? Condition for amount of liquid expelled out. So, if the expansion of liquid is more than expansion of container, then only the liquid will be expelled out now. Okay. So, expansion of liquid is more than expansion of container. So, some liquid will be expelled out. The amount of liquid expelled out is now becomes is, which one is more? Expansion of liquid is more compared with the expansion of vessel. That's why this formula becomes delta Vl minus delta Vc. So, what is the formula delta Vl? Vl gamma L delta T minus Vc gamma C delta T. Na? But we said initially at T1 degree Celsius, Vc is equal to Vl is equal to V. Na? That's why we can write V gamma L delta T minus V gamma C delta T. Na? From this V is common. Delta L minus, sorry, v into gamma l minus gamma c into delta t. This is the required formula for amount of liquid expelled out. Understand? So, for explaining this, what we consider? A container completely filled with the liquid except water at T1 degree Celsius. So, Vc is equal to Vl is equal to V. Now, the temperature is increases to T2 degree Celsius. Then, vessel expands. Liquid also expands. He was asking amount of liquid expelled out, that it is only possible when expansion of liquid is more than the expansion of container. So, how much of amount liquid expelled out? We have the formula delta Vl minus delta Vc. Just I substitute those values, we got one relation. Understand? So, this is about expansion of liquids and applications of expansion of liquids. Okay? Thank you.